Hey, what's up, beautiful people? How are you guys doing? I trust and pray you guys are taking good care of yourselves wherever you are. Remember, guys, health is wealth. A beautiful good morning to you from Georgetown, Guyana. Beautiful, sunny Georgetown. It's a beautiful day today, guys. A beautiful day for a road trip to Barbies. Yes, guys, we're going to go up to Barbies, East and West Barbies, right, Dennis?
Yes.
My cousin is sitting at the back, my nephew is right there, and my buddy is driving. He's my driver since I'm in Guyana. So we're going up Orbis.
Please like, subscribe, and share.
In my previous video, I showed you guys I went back to my childhood days when we were living in Regent Road. I found my school. I'm surprised the school is still there, guys. I spent like 10 years of my early life or earlier life in Georgetown. And guys, memories came back. Not so clear, I can remember certain things, but it's good to go down memory lane, guys. It was awesome, guys. But today, I'm gonna take you guys to the country. My dad came from Quarantine Barbies, and my mom, she grew up in West Coast Barbies. So guys, join me. I'll take you back to where I spent some time in Barbies. Those were the best days of my life, guys. The country life, that's where I fell in love with the country. Fell in love with the country, guys. My grandfather, he had a lot of rice fields, mango farm, coconut farm. We had so much fun in Barbies. That's the best days of my life here in Guyana. West Coast Barbies, I haven't been back there since I came to Suriname, because we normally drive through there coming to Georgetown, but I never really stopped there to see the place. Quarantine Barbies, yes, because my aunt still lives there, and whenever I'm in Barbies, I stop by her. This is going out towards Barbies, right, Dennis?
Yeah.
Dennis is
Dennis to Barbies.
Is my tour
tour
guide.
guide.
Like I said in my previous video, you guys want to do a tour in Georgetown, he is the guy to contact. So we are on our way to Burpees. We're exiting Georgetown now. Dennis?
Yeah, we're still in Georgetown.
We're still in Georgetown, but we're going up
Rupert Craig Highway.
Rupert Craig Highway. And this is the seawall. Can you guys guess why they call it a seawall?
Yeah, behind there is the Atlantic Ocean.
Yeah. And they had to make those barriers that high. When the tide is high, the water comes over. Even that high barrier, the water will seep over here. Oh, this building here? Oh, okay. This was the hotel that turned the hospital, right?
Yeah.
The COVID hospital. This was the COVID hospital. Okay. The arch coming up is the boundary of Georgetown and East Coast. But East Coast, is still in Demerara, right?
No.
No?
East Coast Demerara.
Yeah, East Coast. So this is still Demerara, but that's the boundary of Georgetown and East Coast Demerara. Okay, guys, see that arch? That's the boundary. So right now we're in Georgetown. Georgetown. East Coast, East Coast, East Coast. Now we're in East Coast.
The palm trees and
oh, yeah.
What's up with Dennis?
You got a fruit stand right beside the road? Oh, that's at a truck. Goed verwachting. That's a Dutch name, right? Goed verwachting. You guys see that? Goed verwachting.
All the people who live around here,
uh-huh,
who triumph over our situation.
Good way to put it.
Enough to triumph is Monterey
Pole. Okay. Monterey Pole.
Famous Monterey Pole.
Mm-hmm.
That they already talk about.
Monterey Pole is a French word meaning my rest.
Mon repos.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a French word.
Uh-huh.
Means my rest. Yes. Nice. Zongzing. It seems like you have Chinese taking over Guyana too. All over you can find Chinese now. All over. So this is the famous Mon Repos market. I see all the time on ARD.
Sunny and Sweetie.
Sunny and Sweetie. Okay. Sunny and Sweetie Roti Shop. Right. Yeah, I see this market all the time on ARD. And that's the Newman Repo Market over the road. My mom was born in Buxton because back then my grandfather was the train master. He used to work at the train station in Buxton, right? Or something like that. So my mom, they were living here at that time. So my mom, she was born in Buxton. I don't know, mom, if I'm saying it wrong, train master, you can correct me. So for those who belongs to Enterprise, they're living in the USA or around the world, I'm passing through Enterprise now, guys. If you remember your village where you came from, this is it, Enterprise. Got some nice houses here.
Melanie
Damashala. Okay, this is the area.
Yeah.
Okay. Guys, just to let you know, when I'm asking questions about certain parts of Guyana, believe me, I am not pretending to be ignorant. Honestly, I left Guyana when I was 12 years old. West Coast Barbies, that's where we moved to from Georgetown. And we spent like 3 years in Britannia Village before we migrated to Suriname. I was about 10 years old. 10 or 12 years old. Yeah, no, 12 years old. Right, that's right. 1982, we migrated to Suriname. I know a bit of Barbies, West Coast Barbies. That's where I spent the best days of my life here in Guyana. And I have some knowledge about Rosehall, Port Moran, because whenever I come back to Guyana, that's where I stay. Georgetown. It's just for the past few years I'm coming back to Georgetown. I'm getting myself familiarized again with Georgetown. My last trip 5 years ago and this trip, I'm learning more and more about Guyana, and guys, I'm loving it. It's nice to come back to your homeland, your motherland, and you can equip yourself with knowledge on lots of places here. And that's what I'm doing right now. So I'm not pretending to be ignorant, guys. And more coming up, I know. By passing through here up and down, I can say this is Enmore, but I've never been into Enmore or into these villages. So that's the honest truth, guys.
This village has already had a sugar plantation.
Enmore village.
Enmore.
They still have a sugar plantation in
Enmore?
It closed down now. Okay. According to my family, this is a famous cane juice,
huh?
Famous cane juice stand.
Alright,
too busy to stop. Oh, this is Belfield.
And on your right, past the former President House, President
Barnum House.
Oh, President Barnum House. Oh, President Barnum House.
Yeah.
Oh, this is in Belfield.
Yeah.
Okay.
President.
But you used to live in Belfield?
Yeah, you used to live right there.
The house right now empty?
It's sold, yeah.
It's sold, okay. Mr. Barnum House, President Barnum. We stop here at Ansgrove to try out this cane juice. Got some egg ball, got some puri, some chana. If you're going down to Georgetown or going up to Barbies, right besides the road, you'll find this fresh cane juice stand. And Ansgrove. Alright, let's just cane juice alone. I had a bacon in the office with Sagalefa, you know, just now. Partner, look cane juice. Look, guys. Keep in mind, guys, if you're a diabetic, be careful. Oh. What, this thing here? Yeah, sure. Not something too heavy. Honestly, good cane juice. Nice. Talking because of the camera, talking the truth. How is called this?
Cheese cone.
Cheese cone. This is a cheese cone. But why call it cone? Cheese cone. What a name she's called. I'm just curious.
Same thing for the channel.
Mm.
You can put it in one bag.
Yeah.
I can taste the cheese.
Mm-hmm.
Good? Just crossed over the Mahaika Bridge. I remember this bridge with Mahaika, Maikoni, Abari. Welcome to Region 5. Going towards West Burbies. So wait, Dennis, your grandfather is my great-grandfather, right?
Right, that's correct.
Okay. If you look carefully in front, you'll see a huge tree in the middle of the road. You guys see the tree? It's right in the middle of the road, look. So, that tree has a history. According to my cousin, he was just explaining to me, the tree was planted in the 1700s by the Dutch. It was there. So when they decided to build this main road that's passing down here now, they tried to cut the tree down. And according to the history, whenever they try to cut the tree down, somebody dies. And whenever the machine tried to bulldoze down the tree, the machine always breaks down. All the machines would break down. So they tried to cut the tree down, and after being unsuccessful, they decided to build the road around the tree. So you can't cut that tree down. During the years, the old tree died, and a new tree is what you see there now. And nobody planted that new tree. It sprung up by itself there. Reason, according to history, why you cannot chop that tree down is because, according to the story, the amount of treasure that's buried below the tree, and many lives were lost while burying the treasure. So the tree is protecting the treasure. That's why you cannot cut the tree down. That's according to the Dutch story. That's why the tree is still there. And that new tree sprang up, the old tree died. That's the story behind that tree. Whenever we go to Georgetown from Burbies, Burbies to Georgetown, we always pass that tree. We stopped here in Maikoni. I want to show you guys some of these small replica houses. Look at these houses, guys. See the small houses? You have to pay to go inside, so I'm just showing you the little houses in here. They're so cute, guys. So cute. Neat, guys, neat. So this place is rented. Like if you're doing a wedding ceremony, you can come here and you can take pictures. These are all just replicas. You can go straight up here.
Good morning, sir. How are you doing? Everything good?
Yeah. Look at all these wooden houses. These were the houses in my days. Look at this house. Look at this one. These are some cute houses. Yep. Whenever we see this this bridge, we always know that we are in Burbies. We are close to home when we were small. Because back then, you know, when we used to come from Georgetown, it's like, if are we home yet? Are we home yet? But this bridge used to be the marking point of knowing we are close to home. Yeah, entering the county of Burbies. So officially we are out of Demerara. We are in Burbies. For those who would like a glimpse to see what Ghana looks like today, here is your chance. Use my eyeballs. Use my lens. This is the second longest straight road in Burbies. Straight road meaning without a turn. You see all them coconut trees? So we're going across the Borbis Bridge. Yeah, we're going towards East Borbis, the place of my dad. We're going to my dad's place. So you have to pay a toll to go over the bridge.
How much is the van? How much? 36?
How much? All right, so you pay the toll, that's $3,600. Ooh, $3,600
Ghana dollars. And
That's a bit pricey though, but anyway, you're paying for a pickup truck. So we're going across the Borbis Bridge.
I'll pick up from over there, Dennis.
On your right, future plan to build the oil refinery.
Oh, the oil refinery, okay. Okay. When you see a cow on the road, you're in Guyana. Not India, but Guyana. Yeah, look at all the crabs on the road. We're leaving the Borbis Bridge. We're going now down to East Borbis.
Right?
Quarantine. We gotta turn right? Left. Left.
No, left.
Left. Yeah, we're going to my dad's roots. Yeah, this is the longest straight road in Borbis. Oh, the longest straight road in the Caribbean?
Yeah.
We are approaching Kilcoy. Chesney Kilcoy. This part I can remember because usually when I come to Borbis, this is where I stay. So this is not unfamiliar territory for me. And it's going towards Rose Hall Town. My dad is from Rose Hall Town. The sweetest ginip I eat, brother, was from this area. I can remember the ginip from the market. The ginip was sweet as can be. Now we're approaching Albion. That's Albion Police Station. You get Albion to the estate, yeah. And after Albion, you get Williamsburg, right?
I like the Thailand overall.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah.
The colorful.
The style?
No,
oh, nice.
They look like a wild.
Donkey on the road. Oh, it's a horse. Shoot, I didn't even know my animal. Oh, no, no. After Albany, get Nig. I'm down there. Yeah, look at the Chinese trucks.
Nig. Nig, Nig.
Road to the estate.
Yeah, it's a road to the estate, that's right.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, yeah. I am familiar with this area. Well, not with the side streets, with the main road. I usually go with my cousins to go shopping, grocery shopping around here. But I see there are a lot of businesses put up in this place now, and they're mostly Chinese businesses. Big L Chinese restaurant. I gotta be a big person. Big L. You don't mess with Big L. Blue Moon Supermarket. Good Life Supermarket. At least they got some English names here in Guyana for these Chinese supermarkets. In Suriname, you got these Chinese names you can hardly pronounce. Oh, yeah, you can smell the curry. Y'all can smell in the camera? We get the smelling up right now. Hampshire. Hampshire. Sorry, Hampshire. You guys, the people still got some stand selling fruits.
Oh,
the better you been to the other day?
They went to the girl's side to
Dennis? Okay. I go with you.
There's
an abandoned house to Dennis.
Yeah. You can see all these old houses. I mean, when I say old, I mean old model. I mean, they're in good condition. Some of them they redo. we're approaching Rose Hall Tongue, the place of my dad. I didn't make much trips back and forth Suriname to Guyana, but the times I do come, this is where I would stay, in Rose Hall Tongue. We got turned in the Arch Dam. Yeah, we turn left into this street, going into the arch. Sometimes it's block off this road because it's cool, but I don't know if the road block off. Market. Man, I'm back into Market Dam. You see all the vendors where they stand? Back in the days, this road was mud. Literally mud.
So we make straight out.
Yeah, straight. You see the market in front of me? That's where my aunt was selling. My aunt was selling in the market for number of years and years. When rainfall, we have to, my dad used to leave his car out on the main road, and we gotta walk in here barefoot. Mm-hmm. Going down memory lane.
Can't go in out
there. Yeah.
Actually, my dad never used to live here. Got turned in here. Actually, my dad, I don't know if my dad used to live here, but I know my grandma, she lives, used to live more at the back. This is where my auntie lives.
Yeah, do the road night then,
eh? Right.
Like, make street there, boy, can't.
Right here.
This house?
No, this wood house here. Right here. This is a place where I usually stay at when I come to Burbies. Yeah. And this is the house I grew up in since I was a baby. This is 4th Street, some section. Yeah, that's my aunt's house. It was never like this before. It was a very small house. And over the years, it's been rebuilt, improved. Yeah, you can back out. You can back out. I go walk for now. Mm-hmm. You can show your father for walk out. Yeah, this place is still the same, guys. Still the same. Whenever we come up in Burbies, this is where we normally would spend our weekends or holidays by my auntie. That's my cousin coming there. Yeah, man. Take it easy. Yeah. As a little kid, this is my hometown, man. Can't believe my dad is from this area. All right, let me go. Rose Hall Tongue, Swam section. That's going on to Reef. But when I was a kid, we used to go down to the reef, we used to catch crab. And there's the Nazarene Church, right? Yeah, that's the church I normally come to when I come to Guyana, Rosal. That's the Nazarene Church. This is the property of my grandma.
Who owns it now?
Still in the family, but the house I was on this property, the house, they sold the house.
And that is what, the plant?
Oh, yeah, we used to come at the back here and catch fish. We used to walk and we used to play all of the back here. Huh? Back in the old days.
Go straight over?
Yeah,
right. Alright, good.
You can reverse back.
Huh? Yeah. We can go back straight then?
Yeah, go back straight, sir.
We got something from
connect up. Back with Island Cross.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. We're driving wrong, man. So then make sense to go back, eh? Let me see the place.
Yeah.
I'll be driving. You better drive across the bridge.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, this is the back street. I used to roam all here when we were kids.
Me and my, over
me and my cousin.
You know anybody over there?
No. I really walked these roads, man, when I was a kid. Seriously.
They had road then.
Back then was sheer mud.
Mud
dam. When the rain fall, oh, we used to be crazy. We used to get stuck in mud crazy.
But they need to clean the edge of the grass.
Pass somebody if you hurry. Or maybe you can park here, let me walk up and see. Come back.
Yeah, I can walk and see,
yeah. And then we can reverse back and walk this side.
This is the market, the inside market.
Yeah.
This is?
Yeah. Oh, you can't park right there. Oh, no, you can't park.
Yeah.
Market's not closing up. I can come back here another day and vlog this market early in the morning. Remember that big building up there used to sell suitcases and bags and stuff like that?
Oh, yeah. There's a contraband thing, he's a meth man, you know.
Right. Yeah. But you got to stand here, yeah.
Now the people tell you got to bring everything from the tongue out to the
city. Oh, look right here.
Mama, where are you? Yeah. Oh, yeah, man.
I can turn out here.
Oh, he got a funny smell of the
oh, because the chicken. Fish section and the meat section and the duck, beef, everything
sells
in the back.
Shrimp. Bagani, pulori, chicken foot.
Yeah, people said they come to the hotel market.
What do you think, right?
They buy gilbarka.
Hey, then? The special.